looking back at these 20 years, I was so young when I won. I was all of 18 and a half. I think I turned 19 right after the Miss Asia Pacific. I'll never forget a conversation I had with Mr. Prateek Guha. I asked him, I said, what if I don't win? And he looked at me and he smiled and he said, if you don't win, it will be their loss. And I thought that was a very encouraging thing for an 18-year-old to hear just before embarking on this journey, which had the advantage of preparation and love and encouragement. But at the end of it, it can be very daunting for a person to be alone on that journey and meeting so many amazing women, meeting the organizers, figuring out, navigating the schedules for every day. It was a life-defining experience. And winning was just the crowning glory of that experience. It was all by chance, luck by chance, as they say. I happened to be spotted by a model coordinator when I was about 16 or 17. And she was like, would you like to model? And I was like, I really haven't thought about pursuing a career in modeling. She was like, that's okay, you can do it part-time. You've got a pretty face. Come and do a few fashion shows. And that's how it started. And in the middle of all of this, I remember getting a call from the Times of India asking me to feature in this editorial piece that they wanted to photograph me in. To portray the woman of the millennium. I think that's where Times of India had about spotted me. And I got a call from Times of India saying, would you like to participate in the Miss India pageant? So it was all just luck by chance. It just kind of everything fell into place. Growing up, I was very active in theatre. I did a lot of school plays. In fact, every single year I was a part of the annual school play. Loved the performing arts. Was always very creatively inclined. And so much so that I would watch Madhuri Dixit's movies, or I remember watching 1942 A Love Story and Dil Se, and you know, all those movies growing up late in the 90s and coming back home and enacting the scenes that I've seen in the film, or dancing to the songs, you know. Being fascinated by cinema and acting, but I don't think I ever consciously said to myself that when I grow up I want to be an actor. But it was definitely there subconsciously, because when I look back at the way I responded to cinema and the way films made me feel, and the fact that I was always acting right through school, I guess indicates that, yeah, there was always this desire, some latent key. So I had got the opportunity to mentor the girls last year. So I felt like life had come a full circle. It was just so wonderful meeting girls from all over the country. The one thing that I told all of them repeatedly was, stay true to yourself. Remain authentic to your own heart and your own voice. Find your own voice. I think that's what set each person apart from the other. And yeah, I was very, very proud of all the girls. And just watching them, you know, gain confidence and evolve through the process of the training program. And just see how they, on the final day, their best side shown, you know, just came forth. It was just so wonderful. So wonderful.